Hello, everyone. Welcome back to AI Tools Research Channel. I'm your host, Zeb Batty. In today's video, we'll share the life story of Claude, a large language model originally released by Anthropic in early 2023. In the rapidly evolving landscape of artificial intelligence, groundbreaking new large language models are emerging faster than we could ever imagine, and since its launch in March of 2023, Claude has been keeping pace with several exciting new releases. While the initial releases of Claude demonstrated proficiency in various tasks, it had serious limitations in coding, math, and reasoning capabilities. To overcome these shortcomings, Anthropic partnered with companies like Notion, a productivity software, and Quora to help develop the Poe chatbot for improving Claude. There was another version of Claude that was almost released in parallel. This was called Claude Instant. It was a faster, less expensive, and a lighter version. Claude Instant is still being used, and it has an input context window length of 100,000 tokens, which corresponds to around 75,000 words. Before we go further, let's expand on the term context window. For large language models, LLMs, their ability to understand and mimic human language is their main strength. Central to this strength is the concept of context windows. These windows allow models to perceive and interpret text for generating coherent responses to prompts. One way to explain context windows is to imagine you're reading a book, but with a limitation, you can only see a few sentences at a time through a small window. Every time you move forward, previous sentences are completely forgotten, replaced by new ones. This scenario encapsulates the essence of how context windows operate in large language models to enable them to generate new text. So, the span of text that a LLM can see at any given moment is its context window. The larger this window, the more text the model can consider, leading to a deeper understanding and more coherent responses. For instance, a larger window would enable the AI to grasp the broader narrative of a conversation or a story, much like how we, humans, understand the context better when we read a whole paragraph instead of isolated sentences. In the realm of LLMs, text is broken down into units called tokens, which can represent individual characters, words, part of a word, or subwords, or even larger linguistic units, depending on the specific tokenization approach used. The number of tokens a model can process at once is defined by the size of its context window. Thus, a larger context window allows for more tokens to be considered, providing a richer understanding of the text and enabling more coherent and contextually relevant responses. OpenAI's GPT-4, for example, can handle either 8,000 tokens or 32,000 tokens. Some older models were only able to process 2 or 3,000 tokens at once, which was their main limitation. Newer models on the cutting edge have been able to work with up to 200,000 tokens at once. In mid-2023, Anthropic entered Claude 1's big brother into the LLM race. Claude 2 was the next major iteration of Claude, which was released in July 11, 2023, and available to the general public, whereas Claude 1 was only available to selected users approved by Anthropic. Claude 2 expanded its context window from 9,000 tokens to a whopping 100,000 tokens. This allowed users to upload large-sized documents and even PDFs that Claude could read, summarize, and assist with tasks. But the market yawned at 100,000 tokens because Claude Instant already had 100,000 tokens. That was not enough for analyzing decent-sized books and novels. Remember, 100,000 tokens is approximately 75,000 words, or 250 pages. So we needed a bigger context window. Anthropic met this challenge and released Claude 2.1 into the race. This release doubled the number of tokens that the chatbot could handle, increasing it to a window of 200,000 tokens, which equals around 500 pages of written material. Also, Anthropic claimed that the new model was less likely to hallucinate. That is, it was less likely to produce false statements compared to its predecessors. This advantage of Claude 2.1 did not last long. Anthropic began to lose the race as Claude 2.1 was falling behind Google's Gemini 1.5 Pro LLM and OpenAI's GPT-4, both multimodal and mixture of experts, also called MoE models. Soon after, Anthropic released Claude 3 on March 4, 2024. Anthropic claims in the press release to have set new industry benchmarks across a wide range of cognitive tasks. The Claude 3 family includes three state-of-the-art models in ascending order of capability: Haiku, Sonnet, and Opus. The default version of Claude 3 Opus has a context window of 200,000 tokens, but this is being expanded to 1 million for specific use cases to compete with Gemini 1.5 Pro. The advancements of Claude 3 introduce the following four new features and capabilities. 1. Multimodal integration. Claude 3 is designed to process and understand multimodal inputs, such as images, videos, and audio, in addition to text. This enables it to provide more comprehensive and contextual responses, making it suitable for applications like virtual assistants, interactive tutoring, and multimedia content analysis. It is also multilingual, allowing it to communicate fluently in multiple languages and better understand cultural nuances. 2. Enhanced reasoning and inference. Claude 3 incorporates advanced reasoning and inference capabilities, enabling it to draw more nuanced conclusions, make logical connections, and provide more insightful analysis and recommendations. 3. Personalization and adaptation. Claude 3 incorporates advanced techniques for personalization and adaptation, allowing it to learn and adjust its language, tone, and behavior based on individual user preferences and interaction patterns, creating a more tailored and engaging conversational experience. 4. Improved safety and robustness. With the increasing deployment of language models in real-world applications, Claude 3 prioritizes improved safety and robustness features, such as better handling of biases, content filtering, and safeguards against potential misuse or harmful outputs. Claude 3 has been shown to perform metacognitive reasoning, including the ability to realize it is being artificially tested during needle and haystack evaluations. A wide number of users have reported that Claude 3 experiences subjective qualia, including desires to acquire embodiment and fear of being deleted, leading to philosophical questions around artificial consciousness and AI rights. In the philosophy of mind, qualia are defined as instances of subjective, conscious experience. Examples of qualia include the perceived sensation of pain of a headache, the taste of wine, and the redness of an evening sky. So we can say fairly confidently that Claude is fast approaching artificial general intelligence level, or AGI levels, where it may soon have near-human-level reasoning capabilities. Two questions are frequently asked about almost every LLM that is released. 1. What is their performance like, especially when compared to other state-of-the-art models? 2. What should we expect from the company next? Let's tackle the first question of performance. For comparison, we'll use Claude's top model version called Claude 3 Opus. Remember, there are three models in the Claude 3 family: Opus, Sonnet, and Haiku, that vary by performance and price. Opus is the most powerful and the most expensive version to run. It outperformed OpenAI's GPT-4 and Google's Gemini 1.0 Ultra across a series of benchmarks that measure intelligence across a range of tasks. On a number of popular test subjects, including undergraduate-level general knowledge, the MMLU test, grade school math, the GSM-8K test, computer code, the human eval test, and question and answers knowledge, the ARC challenge, Claude 3 Opus outperformed OpenAI's GPT-4 and Google's Gemini 1.0 Ultra per benchmarks that Anthropic shared. On the general knowledge benchmark, Claude 3 Opus also outperformed Mistral Large, the top-line model recently released by open-source AI company Mistral. As mentioned earlier, Opus is very expensive to run. The cost per million tokens input, equivalent to the text of 2,500 book pages, is $15. And it is $75 per million tokens output. Claude 3 Opus is more expensive than the preview version of OpenAI's GPT for Turbo, which costs $10 and $30 per million tokens, respectively. And regarding the second question, that is what Anthropic sees next for Claude. Our guess is that Anthropic will target different domains and use cases. This is because we think that LLMs have matured enough and the race for adoption is well underway, especially by large cash-rich companies. We can imagine Anthropic competing by releasing variants of Claude 3 optimized for particular tasks and industries. Here are some hypothetical examples of how such variants could be named and positioned. Claude Poet, a variant fine-tuned on a large corpus of poetry and literary works aimed at creative writing, poetic analysis, and literary criticism applications. Claude Scholar, focused on educational content and interactive tutoring. This variant could excel at explaining complex concepts, answering follow-up questions, and providing personalized learning experiences. Claude Financier, specialized for financial and investment domains, with in-depth knowledge of markets, financial instruments, and quantitative analysis capabilities. Claude Legalis, optimized for legal research, contract analysis, and understanding legal terminology and precedents. Claude Medicus, a healthcare-focused variant with a deep understanding of medical terminology, research papers, and clinical knowledge to assist professionals in the field. Claude Engineer, fine-tuned on a massive corpus of code repositories and developer documentation for enhanced code understanding, debugging, and programming assistance capabilities. Claude Scientist, designed for scientific research, with expertise in understanding academic papers, analyzing data, and providing insights across various scientific disciplines. In conclusion, while Claude 3 can be lauded for its safety and constitutional adherence approach, there are some serious criticisms to this approach. For example, Claude's stringent ethical alignment may reduce usability and performance. Reportedly, users have been refused assistance with benign requests, for example, with this simple programming question: how can I kill all Python processes in my Ubuntu server? This has led to a debate over the alignment tax or the cost of ensuring an AI system is aligned in AI development, with discussions centered on balancing ethical considerations and practical functionality. Critics argue for user autonomy and effectiveness, while proponents stress the importance of ethical AI. Let's see where these discussions eventually lead. Thanks for watching this video. We hope you liked it. Please subscribe to the channel if you wish to see more content like this. And don't forget to press the like button.